Welcome to another insightful episode of Me and My Health Stuff. I'm your host, Anthony Hartcher, and it's me today that's going to be sharing insightful wisdom on mental health. So I'm going to be sharing five tips for good mental health. So let's start with tip number one. It's about connection. Yes, all the studies show that connection, human connection, is so, so important. And yes, it can be connection with animals as well. Studies show that animal connection is really good for good mental health. So get connected. Get connected with people that energize you, that support you and love you, and that give back. And so you give to them, they give to you, and you've got this awesome synergistic relationship. Also, connect with nature. Nature is calming for the nervous system. It is so good to get us out of that busy state, that fight or flight stress state. It really calms our nervous system, spending time in nature. And be present. So get connected with being present. So being in the now when you're doing something. So if you're bushwalking, focus on the bushwalking, focus on engaging your senses with the bush and the sounds and the sights and the feeling that you get, and listen in, tune in for crackles that happen in the bush, or a bit of hustle or bustle or movement or some colors. So engage your senses with whatever you're doing. If you're in conversation, then focus on the person, listen, feel, look, have eye contact, put away the phone, put away distractions, and just be totally present. Don't be thinking about what you need to do next. Connect, be present. Okay, so that first point, connection. Connect with people, connect with nature, and connect with being present. So do that this year. Also, move the body, get out and move. Move regularly, make it part of an everyday thing that you're moving your body, and move it in a way you like to move it. It could be with dance or some sort of running or walking. You can be walking with friends, so you're combining connection and movement. You could be doing a walk and talk meeting, so you're doing work and walking and talking and engaging and being present. There's so many ways that we can really serve our mental health by just incorporating it in the day today, as opposed to having to find time for it. You don't need to find time for it. Fit it in. So you can have lunch in the park. That's connecting with nature. It's being present with your food, engaging when you're eating with the senses. So again, you're getting present with the food that you're having. So move your body every day. That's point number two. Number three is to give. So we get so much satisfaction when we're giving ourselves, when we're giving love, when we're giving kindness, when we're helping someone. There is so much satisfaction in the act of giving. You feel amazing. So give more. And it can be giving time to people, just spending time with them, listening, just being present with someone. You can go and look for ways in which you can help others through charity. So certainly, you know, listen out for needs of people. Ask them what their greatest challenges are. What's troubling you now? You got anything I can help you with? Ask whether you could help and offer to help. So if you see someone struggling in the street, go and help them. Don't just whisk past them because you're rushing to the next task. Help them, or even just ask, can I help? And that, even that act of asking, puts a smile on their face because they can see that people care. And that seeing that smile puts a smile on your face and puts a smile on your mind. It's great for mental health. So give more. Give more love. Give more presence, like I mentioned in the first one around connecting. Give more presence to people. Help and support people by random acts of kindness, or by just a constant act of giving, like a constant thought process of how can I give more, how can I serve more. and smile. Give a smile. It is amazing just walking down the street and just smiling to people, getting eye contact. You get the smile back and it makes you even feel even better. It makes them feel great. They walk and continue to walk and they just feel, and they've still got the smile on their face. And then that smile catches the next person and it propagates. So propagate this kindness of smiling. And it doesn't cost anything to give a smile away. My fourth point is to simplify. Simplify your life. And it's this concept of minimalization. So minimalize what you need. Minimize your things, your possessions. And just keep it to some things that you use regularly that really are useful. So, you know, give away the stuff that you don't need. Declutter. And don't buy necessarily things just because it's on a promotional sale. And things are always on sale. When you need it, you get it. But if you don't need it, don't buy it. And don't think, oh, it'll come in useful one day. It's just a waste of money and it just complicates your life. You've got another thing that's crowding your space, the occupying thought processes. And it's so much easier when you have less because you utilize what you have. You think, well, that was worth buying because I'm getting great use out of it. So you feel like there's a return on investment, so to speak. And also, it just simplifies your mind. You're not complicated about wanting to consume more things. You think you want to have what that person's got. Just keep your life simple and it really clears the mind. There's less clutter in your mind by simplifying your life. So declutter your house, declutter your office, declutter the possessions you have, give them away, sell them. And you'll find that you feel more space around you. You feel more space in your mind. And so this can also flow into mindfulness. So, you know, if you've got lots going on in your mind and it's just busy, it's a mess, declutter it by connecting with your senses and just allowing the mind to calm down, to slow down. And that's, you know, clearing up the mind. And you'll find that you feel so much happier, so much more content and fulfilled. So really get rid of those things. Invest more in experiences. So experiences of going, you know, with friends on holidays or family on holidays, you know, so experiencing new things as opposed to buying possessions. Possessions won't, they'll bring you temporary happiness, but the experiences will provide lasting memories, which is fantastic because when you're not feeling great, you can think about the good times you had and the good and be grateful for what you have around you as opposed to focusing on loss or things you don't have. So certainly spending more on experiences, less on things, eliminating, removing, spending less time with people that don't energize you, that don't make you feel a great person. So hang out with people that make you feel great, that just you feel their energy, you feel lifted and inspired by their energy. Spend more time with them. They'll make you feel better. They're typically people that compliment you. They don't expect a compliment back. They help you out. They smile. They give lots of love. They're the people you want to spend more time with. Spend less time with people that zap your energy, that drain you, because that's going to be really helpful for your mental health, is to be uplifted, feel uplifted all the time, inspired by great people around you. And that's the same as social media. So simplify your social media followings. Only follow people that make you feel good about yourself. Unfollow anyone that makes you feel terrible or unvalued or worthless. Just unfollow them. As soon as you see their post, you think that, unfollow them. Don't question it. Just unfollow it. So simplify your social media as well. Simplify your circle of friends, hard to keep it to a tight group of people that really lift you. And then the last point is to be kind. And so, but this is not just kind to others, it's kind to yourself. A lot of mental health issues are this focus on yourself and your perceived self-image and not living up to other people's expectation and your that inner monkey getting, you know, feeding you all these negative thoughts about your unworthiness or things that have happened during your childhood and bringing up past traumas, what I want you to do is let go of that. It's happened, it's been done, and just be kind and caring of yourself and really appreciate what you have, what you're walking around in, because it gets you around. It helps, you know, it helps you be you. You've got unique qualities that other people don't, because as much as you may be envious of others, they're envious of you in other ways. And so what's the point of being worrying about, you know, being jealous of this or envious of this? Just focus on improving yourself, and improve yourself through being kind to yourself and forgiving yourself. And so do that and catch yourself out. Be aware of these moments where you're not being kind to yourself and you're being really judgmental and critical. Stop it, and then focus on what you're appreciated for, what people compliment you for. Focus on those good points, your strengths. Don't focus on the weaknesses. Let go of that. We all got weaknesses. We've got some weaknesses that we can't address. Don't worry about it. Let go of it. Focus on what you're strong in and do more of that, and think of those compliments you've got in the past, and draw gratitude through appreciation for what you have, for the people you have in your life. So be kind to yourself. Use these processes to interrupt and these negative thought patterns, and be kind to others. And that's my five tips. So in summary, it's connect, move, give, simplify, and be kind. So do that more in 2022 and you'll feel a whole lot better, and your mental health will be better served, and you'll be a better human, and you'll love the world more, you'll love yourself more. So please stay tuned for more insightful episodes of Me and My Health Up. Please share it with others if you found this of value, because that helps other people. And that's all I want to do. This is me giving. This is me giving away my knowledge, my experience, to help you grow as a human, for you to be better, and so you can better serve others, and so that we better create an improved society. We can always do incremental improvements. That's what I'm all about. So please share this episode with others. I'd love you to, and stay tuned for more insightful episodes of Me and My Health Up.